the world is a beautiful place that presents unique opportunity to us for realizing our dreams and live a purposeful life of contributing something for betterment of the society. We as human beings have huge responsibilities on the shoulders, but the question is, are we discharging our duties in the best way as we are supposed to, that is, in the proper manner? As in previous modules, I have talked about Kalyug and VUCA and W and possible approaches to overcome it. Here in this module, we will try to find a unique way to address challenges like cultural clashes, insecurity, cutthroat competition, etc. You might agree that the world today needs frameworks, processes, and facilitators for reconciliation, pluralism, integration of views, and healthy interactions for ensuring world peace. And in short, to establish dharma. As Bhagwan Shri Krishna in Gita has advised us to become nimit, that is, a selfless doer in any activity that is in pursuit of dharma. So in this module, we would discuss about Shastrath, purpose of conducting Shastrath, Shastrath versus discussion versus debate, the forms of Shastrath, some interesting topics for Shastrath, and also a video of first of its kind of efforts in conducting the Shastrath.
Since time immemorial, the pursuit of learned people of Bharat has been to seek truth. So strong was their determination that they adopted a multifold approach for this purpose. One such approach was Shastrath. In this, they studied, researched, pondered, contemplated, and discussed thoroughly to derive the real meaning of Shastra. Shastrath was very widely practiced approach of gaining and disseminating knowledge. Also, it served a unique purpose of ensuring that knowledge shared by Acharya and other teachers is reliable and valid. Adi Shankaracharya was one of the greatest masters of Shastrath, and his Shastrath with stalwarts like Acharya Mandan Mish still mesmerizes a lot of us.
Shastrath, if we compare with discussion or debate, then we can say that occasionally we find that competitions are organized and named as Shastrath, but what is carried out does not meet the concept of Shastrath. So I would therefore suggest that to follow the spirit of Shastrath, in case we use it as a title of any program, it will be proper. And I believe that everything is knowledge, and everything is inherent in our Shastra. So if you do not believe this, I am ready to discuss and prove my point. Shastrath are being carried out from ancient time in Bharat, and panel discussions, the group discussions, debates, extempers, elocution, etc. are its offshoot. The Shastrath has some unique features. First of all, it involves mutual questions which are non-moderated, requiring high integrity and knowledge among the participants. Secondly, this is also a different process from Western practice of debate, in which two parties retain their point of view and understanding of the concept. Finally, the winner is judged by the third person. So while the Shastrath is a win-win situation in which the end is reached when either of them humbly accepts that he or she has been enriched by rational, and both have mutually learned something new. Thus, consensus is reached at the end. Thirdly, high maturity is shown by participants irrespective of victory or defeat, that is, vijay or parajay.
Professor, that is a wonderful point. I am reminded of something very interesting incident here. May I share it right now?
Yeah, sure.
We all might have heard the name of Rishi Ashtavakra and Acharya Bandi. Acharya Bandi had a process in which any Shastrath was, if done, then the person who was defeated has to undergo Jal Samadhi. So, once Acharya Bandi and Rishi Ashtavakra set for Shastrath. The background to this story was that Rishi Ashtavakra's father once had a Shastrath with Acharya Bandi and he was defeated. So, he has to undergo the Jal Samadhi. But when Rishi Ashtavakra came for a Shastrath with Acharya Bandi, the scenario was different. Acharya Bandi was defeated and he was ready to take Jal Samadhi. But Rishi Ashtavakra thought that this is not the right process. The purpose of Shastrath should be to reveal the real meaning of Shastra. So, he requested them to stop this practice and follow the pursuit of real meaning of Shastra.
Yes, Ankurji, this is indeed an important lesson. Coming to the fourth point, the arguments are logical and backed up with contents of Shastra. So, finally, Satvikta in organizing the venue, making the start and end of the program make Shastrarth quite unique. So, in this way, we can say that there are some unique things which are there in the Shastrarth, and this is what makes it so interesting for the teachers of management.
Professor, I feel the point you just mentioned is the core foundation of Shastrarth, and you touched an essence. Now, let us explore some guidelines and framework from Nyaya Shastra, which is a wonderful framework to express the points effectively. To enrich the discussion, the participants can present their view by incorporating these five dimensions for a good discussion. These are also known as avayav. The five dimensions are: first, pratigya. This is the point which one wants to convey. Second is the reason or the rationale behind that. Third is the example to substantiate the point that a person wants to explain. Fourth is called the upanaya, which is the relation or the analogy of a point, reason and the example. And finally, the nigaman, that is the concluding sentence. For example, we suggest Shastrath as a pedagogy of learning. It is the point because of its integrative approach, the reason. For example, if we saw a case of Acharya Bandi and Ashtavakra, this is an example, which was also an integrative approach. This is upanaya. Therefore, management teachers can adopt this practice for enriching the management education.
Yes, Ankurji, indeed. Now, it will be useful to see what are the different forms of Shastrarth. So, the first could be Shastrarth in which there is a viewpoint exchange among two or more participants with or without audience, aimed at reaching a consensus with or without audience questions. The second could be viewpoint exchange among two or more participants with or without audience, aimed at victory or defeat. And finally, we can have a version of Shastrarth in which there can be two or more participants taking up audience questions and aim at reaching a consensus. So, should we go for Shastrarth as a way of learning? I think the answer is a big yes. And first of all, it is a better way. And secondly, I just feel, being a teacher of management over the last 20 years, that how painful it would be if the Stanfords and the Harvards come back to us with recommendation to adopt in a form which is branded by them. So, that has been done over the years, that so many things from our literature, our Shastra, they have come from these elite institutions or some other elite institutions. But actually, that is our knowledge, but they have branded in their own way. So, I think that will be the last thing we would want to do. Now, the question is how, that is how we go for it. So, the thing is that Shastrarth is a step-by-step approach. And once we go for Shastrarth, there has to be a viewpoint exchange among two or more participants with or without audience, aimed at reaching a consensus, with or without audience questions, and could be the form we can start with. I would also say that the next thing is that we should pick up a non-controversial topic in Shastrarth to begin with. And most important thing is that keep Satvikta in organizing the venue, start, end of the Shastrarth hall. So that this Satvikta is very important. And finally, I would say that take Shastra as a reference. And before Shastrarth, the participants should discuss with each other about what each aims to cover. And that would help. And see some Shastrarth videos available on internet. For example, we at Banasthali have conducted a few Shastrarth, and which we have made available on the YouTube. So one can see and learn out of it. So some interesting topics for Shastrarth we would like to suggest for the management teachers. Like one could be that in the land of Vasudev Kutumbakam, let us not worry if our business is taken away by the Western businessman. Now, if we keep this as the topic, then here we will have to mention that on one side, it is believed that the world is a family, but also we have a responsibility to our immediate family, to the nearby surrounding, to our nation. So let us ensure the sustainability and strength of them first. And once that is ensured, then let us involve the other people in it. So that can be a perspective. And I think Shastrarth can bring it out, because Vasudev Kutumbakam is sometimes a little misunderstood.
Business should be run in ethical way only. There is no question of any alternative. Learning from Bhagwan Krishna approach, we can understand that dharma and ethos are beyond ethics. So people can think what is the practical approach in consonance with the Indian culture.
Life is about accumulating more and more money, power and respect from others. So when we keep this topic, then it appears very tempting to agree, but another view could be taking inputs from Purushartha theory, and that could be a useful thing for us.
Another is, non-violence is the only way to solve the problems and issues. Here the point is, ahimsa may not necessarily always mean zero hinsa. It also means minimization of hinsa. So we can understand in that perspective.
One more topic could be that could we have all the things that we do be delivered for profit? And this revolves around services like health, education, and should these be catered under for profit and the social businesses, etc.
why companies should do CSR if the business is socially responsible. This revolves around the idea of mandatory CSR. The question is, if any company is already adopting socially responsible practices like environmental care, community care, and their whole process is environmental friendly and socially responsible, so should they be mandated to do CSR? So this topic can also be around a point of discussion for mandatory CSR.
So, dear colleagues, as you might have experienced, that candidates who come for management programs need to be trained in a holistic manner. And in these times when learnability is the biggest asset, the approach of Shastrath can play a crucial role in developing the right attitude. So, I strongly urge that please do consider to include Shastrath as an innovative tool of learning and knowledge dissemination. And I think if you go for it, then you have the chance to ensure that you are called as a teacher with innovation and something which is inherent in our culture, you are taking it up further, and we can develop a lot of original ideas which I think that in the management education are so critical. So that is all from our side in this module, and hope that you adopt Shastrath in your classroom and in all the ways that is possible in your teaching. Thank you very much.